Your Excellencies, dear participants, ladies and gentlemen. At the very beginning, I would like to thank George C. Marshall Center of the German Marshall Center and its alumni association in Montenegro for continuous support and organization of conferences that are directly linked with achievements and challenges Montenegro is facing in the processes of Euro and Euro-Atlantic integrations. It is particularly the case with this year's conference on parallel processes of European and Euro-Atlantic integration of Montenegro results and obligations. The participants will have an excellent opportunity today to hear and discuss with the distinguished panelists who will provide a comprehensive overview of processes, results achieved, and further expected developments. I'm sure that we will all agree on the fact that since regaining its independence, Montenegro has achieved significant progress, both in terms of European and Euro-Atlantic integrations. This progress did not come by its own. It is a result of strong commitment to integration processes which represent strategic priorities of national importance. I'm pretty sure you are all familiar with the specific geostrategic position of Montenegro, actually of the entire region of Western Balkans. Although more than 20 years has passed, some of us clearly remember conflicts that occurred within our region at the time. Fortunately, these events are well behind us. Still, having regarded these and other historical experiences of this kind on Balkans, Montenegro is convinced that the best way for resolving not only our own, but the stability and security of the whole region is within the system of collective security. Such dedication is directly related with the overall reforms implemented in different sectors with the changes already visible in the entire society. Here I am using the word challenges intentionally and changes, as I'm confident that being such a small and traditional society, we are going through fundamental and comprehensive changes in all areas. All the way back in 2008, when we signed the Stabilization and Association Agreement with the EU, the implementation of reforms on internal and external level commenced. The basic EU values, such as rule of law, democracy, human rights, became tangible objectives and the goal of our activities. On the other hand, we will agree that only stable and secure society may ensure an adequate framework for the real democracy. That is where full synergy with the process of Euro-Atlantic integrations becomes obvious. And actually, so far, Montenegro has been following both integration agendas, taking them as complementary processes, enabling in such a manner better results in shorter time. That is how it is achieved that Montenegro today represents the most successful candidate for gaining membership in both organizations, European Union and NATO. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, you all know that at the Intergovernmental Conference on Montenegro's accession to EU held in June 2012, Montenegro started negotiations with the Union on 35 chapters. Following the new approach, the first two chapters are the most demanding ones. Well-known, Chapter 23, Judiciary and Rule of Law, and Chapter 24, Justice, Freedom and Security. In order to support negotiations, the government of Montenegro adopted the program on Montenegro's accession to European Union for the period 2014-2018. In December 2013. The process is going on. I do believe that it is going on in a right way, according to the EU progress reports for Montenegro, the latest one from 2013, and I'm sure that you will all be able to discuss all relevant issues regarding this accession process during the panels you are having afterwards. Along with the agenda of European integrations, a large number of activities are carried out on the path of our Euro-Atlantic integration. From the moment of receiving invitation to join the MEP process in 2009, We have successfully completed three annual national programs. Furthermore, the government of Montenegro adopted the report on the implementation of the fourth annual national program in February this year. We expect that implementation of all activities within the fourth ANMP will be completed by the end of June 2014. In this context, I would like to emphasize Montenegro's commitment to implement reforms in four key areas concerning the integration in NATO, the rule of law and all other political criteria, reforms of intelligence sector, modernization and reforms of defense sector, and decreasing public support for Montenegro's NATO membership. In all these areas, progress is carefully followed and yearly evaluated together with our partners, NATO member states, and I am pleased to say that there is an overall agreement that Montenegro is a success story and reliable partner when it comes to adopting the criteria and standards of the alliance. There is no doubt that the NATO's open door policy is an opportunity for Montenegro to become the first next member of the alliance. As the best prepared aspirant country, we will continue with intensive political dialogue, expecting that the open door policy will be effective and our mutual achievements recognized at the upcoming summit in September. In concluding, I would like to emphasize that it is of uttermost importance that especially young people understand the reasons why we started these integration processes and what are the goals we strive for. To understand that gaining membership in such international organizations, along with other modern and developed countries in the world, brings more advantages than risks. I hope this conference will be an opportunity to cross the arguments, to better perceive and understand our needs and efforts necessary for successful implementation of Montenegrin foreign policy objectives for joining the EU and NATO. I would like to thank you all for your attention, and I really do wish you a successful work.